A bit of intriguing gossip from the UK's royal family caught my attention recently. Do you know who's been asserting themselves in the power dynamic between King Charles and Queen Camilla? Let's spill the royal tea. You know how body language can sometimes tell more about a relationship than words? That's exactly the case here. Analysts who are professionals in this subtle art suggest Queen Camilla is the one leading the royal dance, more often than not. But don't mistake this for any discord. King Charles and Queen Camilla are still absolutely smitten with each other. It's just that Camilla's presence gives Charles a rock to lean on, a sturdy ship in the tumultuous seas of royal duties. Here's a tasty tidbit from a recent outing. Our favorite royals graced the Sandringham Flower Show in Norfolk with their presence, basking in the scent of blooming beauties, their last hurrah before heading off to their holiday in Balmoral. Picture the scene. They meander through stalls, eyeing fresh produce, savoring the delights on offer. And get this, Camilla nibbled on a pie that oddly resembled her hubby of 2+ decades. Talk about love bites. It's not just royal watchers saying this. Darren Standen, a bona fide body language guru, confirms that the affection between Charles and Camilla is alive and kicking. Charles and Camilla are soulmates, he proclaims on behalf of Betfair. Like a scene out of a romantic movie, he points out how they can't seem to stop stealing glances, sharing jokes, and lost in each other's eyes during public outings. It's like they're still in that honeymoon phase, even after all these years. And that constant eye contact, pure, unadulterated love and trust, according to Standen. If that's not hash relationship goals, I don't know what is. These two may embody the essence of tradition in their clothing, conduct, and values, but there's a subtle evolution happening. The late queen's etiquette still influences their public persona, but they've managed to grow, finding more confidence, a more genuine connection with their subjects. Charles, bless his heart, might be a stickler for tradition, but don't let that fool you. Standen notes an interesting shift. Charles appears more comfortable, more himself when Camilla is near, likely because of her natural extrovert charisma. So, while she may be the dominant one, it's a dance they both seem to enjoy. Well, we're back at it again, folks, delving deeper into the dynamics of the royal pair. I've got to tell you, Camilla is not one to be overshadowed, not even by a king. She steps into the limelight with grace and confidence during public appearances, the alpha in this royal pack. And Charles, far from resisting, seems to find comfort in her strong presence. That's not to say they don't enjoy their moments apart. Remember their student days at Sandringham? Physical distance, sure, but emotional distance? Not a chance. Intriguingly, despite their individual temperaments, Camilla's extrovert nature seems to draw out a more relaxed Charles, adding another layer to their harmonious dynamic. But hey, let's not get stuck on the serious stuff. The royals know how to let their hair down too. Now, who doesn't love a bit of holiday gossip? The royals, despite their packed schedules, know the importance of some good ol' R&R. You'd think with their royal coffers, they'd be globetrotting to exotic locations, right? Well, you'd be surprised. Their favorite spots are typically European, a testament to their appreciation for tradition. Princes William and Charles, Princess Kate, and our leading lady Camilla often pack their suitcases for work. They traverse nations, engage in royal duties, sometimes for weeks on end. But when it comes to their downtime, they prefer destinations closer to home. Even though they could charter a flight to the farthest corners of the world, the royals keep it somewhat modest. Take Kate and William, for example. These lovebirds are known to enjoy staycations in the Scilly Isles, but they aren't averse to some tropical delight in the Caribbean or the snowy escapades in the Swiss Alps. King Charles and Queen Camilla share the love for these quaint European getaways too. But there's one sunny Greek island that holds a special place in their royal hearts. And can we take a minute to talk about the sublime, mystique coastline of St. Vincent? Ringed by the Atlantic and Caribbean seas, this gem of a place offers 9 distinct beaches and a treasure trove of coves waiting to be explored. The royals, particularly Prince William and Princess Kate, seem quite smitten by this island paradise. Last seen there in 2019, they shared this sun-soaked retreat with their little ones, Prince George, Princess Charlotte, and Prince Louis. Fun fact, Mystique, bought for a mere £48,000 in 1958 by Colin Tennant, 3rd Baron Glenconner, is now estimated to be worth a whopping £1, 25 million. Talk about a royal investment. All right, let's keep the momentum going, folks. We're delving into the royal family's preferred vacation spots, and trust me, it's not all crowns and castles. In fact, it's all about soaking up the sun, the sea, and some splendid scenery. Remember Mystique, the slice of paradise we just talked about? Princess Margaret, God bless her soul, was gifted a 10-acre plot on this private island. Here, she constructed Le Jolie O, an Oliver Messel-designed neo-Georgian mansion with a theatrical flair. Now, even though this villa is still up for grabs to rent, our friends William and Kate have a different preference. Last time they were there, they chose to stay at the Villa Antilles, a contemporary colonial-style property with 5 bedrooms, owned by William's buddy, Andrew Dunn. All right, next up on the royal vacay tour, Corfu. Yes, the northernmost Ionian island in Greece. Snuggled between the Adriatic Sea and the coastlines of Albania and Italy, it's a British favorite, especially for Charles and Camilla. It's the epitome of Mediterranean beauty, with its splendid climate, sweeping views, and an abundance of flora and fauna. With some 4,000 olive trees and an estimated 6,000 varieties of herbs and flowers, it's a veritable Garden of Eden. Their abode while on the island is the Rothschild Villa in Corasia, humorously dubbed the Kensington Summer Palace. There's more to Corfu than just its beauty. It holds a special place in royal hearts as the birthplace of Prince Philip, Queen Elizabeth's late husband. It's an island brimming with waterfalls, lush forests, and a regal history. Now shifting gears from the sunny coasts to the Swiss Alps, let's talk about Klosters. It's a picture-perfect Swiss village with a touch of class and international flair. Its mountain setting, a favorite of King Charles, has been the backdrop of numerous memorable family moments. The late Princess Diana often visited the resort with their young sons, William and Harry. In fact, it's in Klosters that William and Kate's official relationship debuted in 2004. And here's a juicy tidbit for you. It was also the spot of their first public smooch. Taking a break from the holiday chatter, let's acknowledge a serious chapter in recent history. The COVID-19 pandemic shook the world, compelling everyone, including the royals, to hunker down and isolate. Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip were no exception. In 2020, the couple was shielding at Windsor Castle, just like the rest of us. Far from causing a strain, this time together seemed to have brought them even closer. A silver lining in the gloomy cloud of the pandemic, wouldn't you say? Rolling on with our royal tale, it's time we spilled some tea about the late Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip's life under lockdown. I mean, if you thought royal life was all crumpets and tiaras, you're in for a bit of a surprise. You see, just like any long-married couple, they had their moments of, shall we say, spirited discussion. As the COVID-19 pandemic raged on, the couple was holed up in the HMS bubble, along with 20 dedicated crew members. Now, you'd think being in the company of your spouse for 73 years would ensure smooth sailing, right? Well, not always. According to an unnamed royal aide, our royal couple had a bit of a tiff. Philip, in a bit of a huff, was heard saying, "Oh, do shut up, you silly woman. I mean, talk about keeping things real, am I right?" But Queen Elizabeth, bless her, had a witty comeback up her sleeve. She promptly responded with, "I am not a silly woman. I am the queen." Quite the mic drop, wouldn't you say? Now, this could seem a bit shocking to some, but hey, we all have our moments, even if you're a monarch. This dynamic duo wed way back in November 1947, and their journey together spanned over 7 decades, weathering many a storm within the monarchy. Prince Philip passed away in April 2021 at the ripe age of 99, with Queen Elizabeth following him a little over a year later, having celebrated her platinum jubilee. Now, moving on to the reign of King Charles and Queen Camilla. The couple, who tied the knot in a somewhat low-key ceremony in April 2005, have now been together for close to 2 decades. Just before their summer vacation, the couple made their final public appearance at the Sandringham Flower Show on July 26th. And here's where we add some fun to our story. An intricately decorated homemade pie at the show caught Queen Camilla's attention. Pointing at the pie, which had a cheerful face with an ornate pastry crown, Camilla couldn't help but exclaim, "It looks just like my husband." She then called Charles over to share the chuckle, a moment of lightheartedness indeed amidst the weight of royal duties.